Oh, bananas, no problem. Let's make some banana bread. First, we're gonna brown a stick of salted butter in a pan, and browning butter is really easy. You really just have to put it on low to medium heat, and you're gonna stir it every few minutes. You're pretty much cooking the solids that are in the butter, and you'll see as it becomes more golden brown as the butter cooks. So it's probably been about 5 minutes now, and as you can see, the solids in the butter have pretty much turned brown, as you can see the color of that in the video, and that is exactly what you want. So the effect that browning the butter does, it gives it a very nutty taste. So if you ever do this, you're gonna start to smell a very nutty smell. I was standing right there, so 350, go ahead and set your oven. All right, ingredients. Get some cinnamon, make sure you have those very ripe bananas, banana extract, vanilla extract, baking soda, eggs, granulated sugar, light brown sugar, flour, and some sea salt. This is everything you're gonna need. So keep in mind that very ripe bananas are typically much more sweeter, right? As you can see, when I peeled the skin off of those bananas, they still look really good. You just want them really ripe. So I let these bananas sit on top of my refrigerator literally for like a week, and finally they looked perfect. So now you're gonna blend those three large bananas and just mix them really good. I personally like a few little chunks. I don't like it like when it's completely pureed. That's not really my thing. You can do that if you want, but it's just not my thing. So now you're gonna go ahead and pour that brown butter inside of your bananas, and you're gonna mix that. It doesn't take that much mixing, honestly. Just make sure they're really incorporated. Scrape down the sides, make sure you're getting all of your bananas as much as possible, and butter incorporated together. And I'm telling you guys, when you do this, the smell alone, now this is just bananas and brown butter, but the smell is crazy. Now we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna add in our vanilla extract and our banana extract. And you just need a tiny bit. The vanilla extract, I believe it was about maybe a tablespoon. And then the banana extract, I mean, literally maybe a quarter of a tablespoon. You don't need that much. Go ahead and crack your two eggs in another bowl first. Always crack your eggs in another bowl first, just to make sure if there's any weird stuff in the egg or like shells, you know, you've cracked it in another bowl and not inside the batter that you're making. And you're gonna mix all that stuff together, really just until it's incorporated, not very long at all. Okay, we're almost done actually. So dry ingredients, you're gonna put them in a bowl and mix them all. All right, so we got the sugar, we got the flour, cinnamon, salt, and baking soda. Just mix them. After you've mixed that really good, making sure that there's no lumps, go ahead and add those dry ingredients inside of the banana mixture. Add it all in at one time, and then you're gonna mix it until it literally is incorporated. So you don't wanna over mix this batter, right? Just mix it until it's incorporated. All right, so this is what it should look like once it is all mixed. So you see, the only chunks that you see really should be the bananas. But what I'm doing right here is you're gonna take your spatula, you're scraping down the sides, and you're scraping up the bottom, and you're just making sure that everything is mixed, right? So you're not like beating it in the mixer right now. You're just taking a spatula and softly just folding it just to make sure everything is incorporated. Next, you're gonna take that and put it in your grease pan. Now you're about to throw it in the oven. Anytime I make a cake or bread or anything, I like to hit the pan on the counter just to have the air bubbles come up, and then you're gonna throw it in the oven. And this is your end result. And it's delicious. You're gonna love it.